BTP, Big Business Technology for Small Business.
Good morning. Welcome. It's Michael Jenkins here from BTP. How are you today? I want to talk to you about Windows 7. Windows 7 is now approaching end of life. So what exactly does that mean? And you're going to see some scary words like you must upgrade. Windows 7 is end of life. We're not going to support you. You must do this now. Windows 10, you must upgrade to Windows 10. You're going to see all this stuff out there. What is it all about and what does it all mean? First of all, forget about the marketing. The word must, well, you don't need to upgrade to Windows 10, no. There are very good reasons to do that and upgrade to Windows 10. However, forget the must. You need to do it in your own time and as you need to do it. Now, there are some reasons why, yes, you would march ahead and do the upgrade. Security being one of those, patches being another. Yes, I would look at upgrading to Windows 10, but the word must, it puts such an impost on small business. People worry about these things, and you don't need to. So what does end of life mean? End of life is a traditional period where Microsoft, a certain number of years after a product's been released, will stop releasing service packs and updates and patches, and will also eventually stop supporting in the TechNet forums and things like that. What does that really mean? Well, Windows XP was end of life and 10 years later still going. And people were still using it and they were still putting fresh copies of it on new machines and XP was just refusing to die. So when Microsoft end of life something, yes, that's a corporate stance. Yes, we no longer support this product and we're not going to bring updates along. It doesn't mean your product expires. It doesn't mean it no longer works. And it doesn't mean every other vendor out there are going to stop supporting it. So after end of life, you might still find printers that work with Windows 7. You might still find other products, accounting packages and things like that still support Windows 7. A lot of packages out there don't have the same timeline as Microsoft because they don't have the same length of time available to them for bench testing and making sure the application works correctly. So Windows 7, is it going to be around after end of life? Yeah, it's going to be around. People love Windows 7 and they hung on to it. Now, Windows 10, should you upgrade? Well, I'm going to say yes as well. I understand if you hang on to your Windows 7, but please plan to go to Windows 10. Because at end of life, you do stop getting patches and you will find eventually, I think it's just starting now, antivirus companies are stopping support for XP. So yes, XP hasn't been supported a long time, but our antivirus vendors, Trend Micro, people like that, have been still scanning for viruses on those things. So end of life didn't mean a lot to XP. But one day it'll happen on Windows 7, things will stop being produced that are compatible. But the biggest thing is the security aspect. Windows 10 is far more secure. It has patches that are new, it has updates, it's got products that are newer, it's fresher, it's faster on the older hardware. There's a lot of benefits and bonuses to going to Windows 10. Windows 10 had a bit of a sketchy start. A lot of rumors flying around about privacy that it breached and all sorts of things. Then it had the mandatory updates. People on very limited small bandwidth connections downloading 10 gig for updates was just out of the question. Microsoft have listened and they're making changes to the way they do updates and then making changes to the way things are working with the privacy. Windows 10 is evolving into a very good product. It actually started as a pretty good product, but it's just getting a lot better. So should you hang on to your Windows 7? I'm not going to say that end of life means you need to march out and replace every machine you've got and put in Windows 10. I'm going to say that as a small business with a budget, with limited resources and time with the outages of rebuilding machines, that you plan to move to Windows 10. And we can help you with that plan. So I'm not asking you tomorrow to go upgrade all your machines to Windows 10. I still love Windows 7 myself, but I'm planning to move everything to Windows 10. It's a plan. It's not a must do, it's a can do, should do, and you probably will do it. But I'm not gonna say it's a must do because that just puts an impost on you that you just don't need. And it's not a true thing. You don't have to do it. If you wanna live with all the insecurities and you wanna live with other things, but your world, it all works. So you come into work, your accounting package works, your payroll works, you can print, you can scan, you can surf the net. Everything works the way you want it to work. Then end of life means nothing to you except you're not going to get that security and support. However, that is the reason why I would move forward, is the security and support. So look, with all the jargon coming out, read between the lines. Ignore the must-dos, ignore you have deadlines and it's expiring and all this sort of stuff. It's not going to die on you. It's still going to work fantastically well. So read between the lines. I would be reading into it that I now need to start thinking about moving to Windows 10. I need to ask my IT guy, we can help you, to move you towards Windows 10 and explain the differences and how it all works. If you are on Windows 10, then even though that's not end of life, don't forget new versions of Windows 10 are coming out all the time, and only running the latest version gives you the latest features and the latest security, and also starts to implement some of those changes that Microsoft are bringing along. So even with Windows 10, constantly upgrading is a good idea. I know it sounds like a bit of a money grab by Microsoft saying that you need to move to a new version of Windows and you must do it. It's not really a money grab, they're just worried about your security and things like that. They are bringing down the cost of OSs over time usually. So really they're not after a money grab, they're trying to look after your security. So look, your aging fleet, talk to us about it. Let's get you on Windows 10. Let's do it at your time. We know you're a small business. We know you can't have the down and outage of it. We need to plan it around you guys and also around the readiness of your software and the features that you use. So ignore the expiries and end of lives, but in general, start planning to change to Windows 10. Right, that's today's little message for you. Hope you got something out of that, and have a great day. A wet day here in Adelaide today, a very wet day actually. Expecting a lot more wind, but it hasn't arrived, not yet. But glad to see some rain falling from the skies, and hopefully into the weekend as well. We'll see you later.